Maliha Zahid's journey through academic entrepreneurship began like most, with a fortuitous lab discovery. Her tenacity in seeking out the resources available to her in Pitt's innovation ecosystem to translate her discovery from the benchtop to the market, and her success in shepherding two discoveries through the early commercialization phases have resulted in her selection as the inaugural Pitt Emerging Innovative Award.
A third of my PhD that was done in Dr. Paul Robbins' lab, the work was on finding peptides, kind of fishing for peptides out of a very large pool for something that would target the heart. It took about 6 tries, and I was this close to giving up, and 2 years of my life, but we found a phage that targets the heart, and we found the peptide that was responsible. In 2010, that work was published, and at the same time, we applied for a patent.
It took nearly 5 years for the patent to be issued, and Zahid did not initially pursue further development of the idea.
So when it did come through, I was nicely surprised and I was very excited. And I called my mother up and I told her about the peptide. And she asked me a very simple question. She asked me, oh, who benefits from this peptide? And that question, I was like a deer in the headlights. I thought about it and I said, well, this peptide led to me writing an abstract. That was an oral presentation at the American Heart Association, a paper, a PhD, and now a patent. So it really benefited me greatly. There was complete silence on the other side of the line for about 3 seconds, and then a very dry voice came on and said, well, good for you. That was like getting slapped in the face with a wet fish. That was the moment of realization that this peptide, this paper, this patent, it really doesn't mean anything or does anyone any good without it being commercialized.
Zahid received approval from her lab's director, Dr. Cecilia Lowe, to apply for the Pitt Innovation Challenge to obtain funding to begin exploring commercialization of her discovery. To her delight, she was one of the 3 winners of the $100,000 top award in 2016. Which opened up a whole new world to her at the university.
All of a sudden, I got introduced to so many departments that I didn't even know existed. And I got to know about the commercial side of things, and I consider Paul Petrovich and Phil Brooks my early commercialization mentors. And it really was a steep learning curve because I knew nothing about the process to begin with.
Innovation Institute entrepreneur-in-residence Phil Brooks said it was clear that Zahid would pursue the commercialization process with focus and intensity.
She's incredibly committed, and that commitment carried over into the commercialization process with First Gear. She wasn't familiar with these business elements, but she really jumped into them. Core elements of the First Gear program are an expectation that you do 25 customer discovery interviews to identify whether people are interested in your innovation. When people complete that program, it makes them eligible for the national I-Corps program, where they get $50,000 in funding, and the expectation is a minimum of 100 customer discovery interviews.
Zahid progressed to the national NSF I-Corps program, for which she was paired with business mentor Chip Dougherty, who helped her negotiate her first pivot on the path to market.
She started out with the idea that the main application, the first application for her technology is going to be in the diagnostic realm. And she's right, it is a better agent for carrying radiopharmaceuticals to myocytes. She has the papers on it, she has the data on it, she's got the images. This shows that's the work. The problem is no one really wanted a better diagnostic than they currently have. Through the discovery of that process, she was able to figure out, though everybody thought it would be a great vehicle for delivering a therapeutic to the myocytes.
With her commercialization path becoming clearer, Zahid said she is eager to keep her momentum going.
I want to apply for another PFI NSF grant to develop this technology further, to find out the best, most optimal cargo to target to the heart. do some feasibility, preliminary feasibility studies, then start an SBIR, apply for SBIR funding for a startup company as the next step along the way.